Miss Lisa, we can now start.
Thank you, Gomer. Good afternoon, everybody. I am Marie-Lisa Dakanay. I'm the president of the Institute for Social Entrepreneurship in Asia. Welcome to the fourth webinar of the COVID-19 Social Enterprise Response and Visioning Effort that ISEA pursued as a response to COVID-19. There are actually two objectives of the webinar series. The first is to share, network, and collaborate so that we can actually develop a responsive relief and recovery effort, as well as an effort to build back better in facing COVID-19 together as a social enterprise sector in Asia. The second objective is to reconfigure what we were supposed to launch as social enterprise acceleration platforms for the sustainable development goals. No? In March 2020, when the pandemic happened, we were about to have a joint conference with the UNSCAP to actually launch what we called social entrepreneurship SDG acceleration platforms. At the time, there was already a grim forecast that the sustainable development goals of zero poverty and all the other sustainable development goals like reduced inequality and gender equality and all that were not going to be met by 2030. And the UN system was looking for actors who would help to accelerate the sustainable development goals. And they were looking to social enterprises and social entrepreneurship practitioners in the Asia-Pacific region. That's why they partnered with the Institute for Social Entrepreneurship in Asia to launch and explore this social entrepreneurship SDG platforms. And one of those platforms was actually a platform where Venus Wadaya, who is our subject for the webinar today, was very active in, and that was promoting the benchmarks for transformational partnerships and women's economic empowerment in agricultural value chains, which was about the promotion of empowerment of women and men small-scale producers, promoting resilience, promoting food security. And in the face of the pandemic, I think these issues, especially food security, have even become more important. Anyway, the webinar series today is the fourth. Our first webinar was with the World Fair Trade Organization Asia. The second was with Dompet Wapa. The third was with CICIP in Vietnam. And now we have the fourth, and we're really honored to have with us a high-level team from Venus Wadaya. Venus Wadaya, for those of you who are not that familiar with them, is actually a pioneering institution promoting social entrepreneurship in Indonesia. But and with us is a team led by Pak Bambang Ismawan, who's actually the founding chair of Venus Wadaya. So we're very lucky to actually have him with us this afternoon. So without much ado, I'd like to turn over the floor to the Venus Wadaya team, with Pak Indro and Emilia, but leading the team is Pak Bambang Ismawan, the founding chair of Venus Wadaya.
Thank you. Thank you, Lisa. Hello, everybody, my friends. As a co-founder of ISEA, I'd like to welcome you all to this very interesting and very important webinar on the COVID-19 and the implication of that and our response about that, etc. So this is an opportunity. Maybe without COVID-19, we never met like this. That's why it is really a good opportunity that we utilize this situations to meet together and listen and get to know each other very closely. I think it is a very good initiative to utilize the situation working from home. And now we are working from home in an Asian dimension. I will soon let the team from Binaswaraya, that's the presenter will be Emil and Mas Endro will as a moderator. And before that, I like to introduce a little bit about Binaswaraya. Binaswaraya has established in 1967 by Pancasila Farmer Association. Is a social entrepreneur and promoter for social entrepreneurship. Is a foundation engaged in business development, community empowerment, especially social and solidarity economy. Our focus development in five areas was community-based self-help organization development, microfinance services and development, community-based production and business development, training and education in self-reliance, and local-specific development. This development community-based institution, such as self-help groups, cooperatives, rural banks, publishing and digital media, training and consultation. Giving recognition through Trubus Kusala Swadaya is a kind of award for individuals, institutions, and organizations every 2 years. Binaswaraya is one foundation with 10 active business groups, limited and cooperative for community-based social economic development. Trubus is our magazine, means proud. And we are working this kind of situations, and I'm very happy that Endro and Emil will talk more about our activities related to the COVID-19. Now I like to a bit about how Binaswaraya works. Binaswaraya as social entrepreneur has direct activities. Next, Emilia. Direct activities and to promote self-help groups, cooperative microfinance institutions, publishing digital and media, agriculture, industry, trading, environment, cultural and local wisdom, advocacy, education and training, and consultancy. We are working this area direct to the people and with the impact of social value, empowerment, and economic development. This is impacted to individuals and community. But when we are cooperating with other organizations, networking with and cooperative NGOs and CSOs, government institutions, private sector, banks, professional organizations, university network, and aid agencies. Our impact not only limited to individuals and groups or community, but at the regional level, sectoral, and even national level. We are cooperating with national government, and we are very proud that during 20 years, we are promoting around 1 million self-help groups around the country. And the approach number three is related to promoting inclusive development system. And by promoting social solidarity economy, and we consider it will help to impact it at the national and international level by promoting regional government regulations, laws, etc. So this is short about Dinas Swadaya. And Emil will talk about how we respond and how we impacted by the COVID-19 and how we respond and together with other friends in Indonesia. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, my friend. Now, Indro, maybe can continue.
Okay. Thank you, Pak Bambang. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Lisa, Pak Bambang already mentioned my name. So, yes, my name is Indro Surono. So, I will be the moderator of this webinar series, SERF of the ICA. Actually, I just joined with Pak Bambang in Bina Swadaya Foundation since like last year, officially become the board member of Bina Swadaya Foundation since August last year. But I have been know Pak Bambang and work with the Bina Swadaya Foundation for many years, I think since 1996 until now. And I'm also working with an NGOs and in rural development and also agriculture, women empowerment. Especially, my specialization is on organic agriculture. So this is a short introduction about me. So today we will have a webinar series about lesson learned from Bina Swadaya. Pak Bambang already mentioned a little bit how that Bina Swadaya affected by this pandemic COVID-19, and then how we can survive, yeah, and then also how we have to switch or we have to face this situation, the pandemic situation, in order we can keep continue ourselves to be survive and as well as to continue supporting our partners, especially for micro and small micro enterprise, which is become our main target group and beneficiaries in Indonesia. So today we will have Ibu Emil, Emilia Prasetyo. She is now is the secretary of Bina Swadaya Foundation. And she has been working with Bina Swadaya for many, many years. And she has like specialization on social entrepreneurship and gender issue. So we will have around like, I think we still have around more than 1 hour for our webinars today. So we will have like first Emil will be speak for around 20 to 30 minutes, and then the rest 30 minutes we may continue with the question and answer, and then in the last 5 minutes I will let Lisa to make a closing for this session. So regarding the question and answer, you can write your question on the chat, yeah, and then I can read and then we'll read during the question and answer. Or if you want to speak directly, then I can also mention you, but please raise your hand so then I can know you, and then I will give you the time to speak. Okay, so I think now, Bu Emil, I let you to speak on behalf of Bina Swadaya Foundation.
Thank you, Pak Indra. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for the time. And yes, I'm spending more than a half my life in Bina Swadaya, and hopefully, and this is the hard time because it's very sleepy time, and I will give you I will give you more a picture so you can see what we have done from Bina Swadaya. And Pak Bambang already mentioned in the first that Bina Swadaya and Trubus Bina Swadaya is the same. Bina Swadaya is foundation and Trubus Bina Swadaya is a private company under the Bina Swadaya Foundation. And for starting from June, we try to rise and living in harmony with COVID-19. Pak Bambang already mentioned too that our journey is Bina Swadaya, the mission is helping poor people, and we do training, assistant poor people, agriculture supported, social business, and we have a business to support our goal in Agriculture Magazine. Trubus is a brand of our magazine, and we have also publishing training center in Wisma Hijau, catering services, cooperative, also consultancy, and humanitarian and emergency response. All our business we do in social enterprise. In the name of the new brand is Trubus Bina Swadaya. Impact of COVID-19 to Trubus Bina Swadaya Group is very hard because all business going down. And what we do? Fortunately, we have a meta leader, Pak Bayu is our chairman, board chairman, and he lead us to identify the critical business function, also the recovery strategy. We establish a crisis management structure. We review existing policies, procedure, and response plan. We determine trigger point to activate the business continue plan and monitoring the implementation. In a week, we have two hard meeting to monitor all we have done in during the COVID pandemic. Also, we have an agile and responsive communication function. We should resilient. We should adaptive business, and we should do synergy. Resilient strategy from Trubus Bina Swadaya is continue operation of business that allowed to open during lockdown. We have shop, agriculture input shop. We open in the from the 9 only for 3 p.m. Also, we see switching main business mice to catering and online food food selling. In public media, we pushing to digital media. We make much ebook, magazine, online training, webinar. We have twice webinar in a week, social media campaign and promotion. And for cooperative partner, we have a debt restructuring program. In crisis management structure, we work from home because a government policy that we should work from home. 30% employees still work with safety protocol. For example, in True Bus Shop, we still open for customer, and so also in finance and several in kitchen. Also, we have update daily employee and family health data. We give supplement for all employee. Review existing policy, procedure, and response plan. Every week we should manage our cash flow because it's hard cash flow for us. 30% business is closed. Also, we have employee restructuring and salary deduction. Even we have a hard time during the COVID, but we still care about our partner. For external, we have a fundraising for our partner. Also, we give food and health equipment. We support donation to partner for women cooperative member. Also, we give aid 200 packets for self-protection for hospital near our office. We distribute 20 face wash portable around our office in Depok. Also, we have crowdfunding system for community around us for staff to do donation for our charity program. We give the aid food for our member in Gunung Putri, and the beneficiaries is 500 household. We have a soft marketing strategy too, using social media campaign in work from home. We campaign about urban farming. We campaign about healthy food. This is a direct and indirectly attract demand to home gardening, farming kit, ebook, webinar to TPS activities, because during the coronavirus, the agriculture product is very high demand. Everybody need activities at home, when stay at home. We also campaign about a healthy lifestyle, how to imbues the immune body using the herb. We have a campaign about how to make hand sanitizer, how to make disinfectant. Also, because school from home, we give the information about the site to school at home, from rumah belajar, ruang guru, Genius. We give information to people and to our community too. We have solidarity action too. We have super sales books because we cut off the price until 90% special for activities at home. And this is helpful book. This is the hard copy book. It's very expensive, but we give them very, very low prices. Also poster for kids, novel, everything that we can do at home for activities at home. We super sale a book 90% off in online platform, in Shopee, in Tokopedia. Is everything is 90% off. The business should be continue because at June, the government is okay that we can, even in the new normal or non-normal, we can go to the office. But we have the challenge because new normal, we should reposition in internal process, we should have a new standard operating procedure, and we should have the new business process. Also, our community getting going down because of business is going down, is many is jobless. In our another business in community development program, internet is not suitable for every area in 33 provinces in Indonesia. Also, we have a technology backward. We cooperation with village government to provide internet services for Zoom meeting, for Google Meet. Also, we should redesign curriculum that suitable for poor, for low education. We using short video, WhatsApp group, but is very very limited because for WhatsApp group we only can share video only for 2 or 3 minutes. Using Instagram, we have a limited time too. And we using the local assistant. We using the local cadre to help our program in community development. Also, we connected with a local policy in the village, in the sub district, also in the district. It's very very local policy. But Trubus Bina Swadaya should be raised starting from June toward. As our founder said, that Bina Swadaya have passion, have a compassion that our business is engaged in the business development, community empowerment, especially in social and solidarity economy. So the goal of Trubus Bina Swadaya is healthy and happy family, strong small and micro enterprise in village, advanced farmer and advanced village, also productivity and have the sustainability. How we rise together with partner? Social enterprise, our business is embedded with social impact. We try, for example, with Kekemir farmer. Business and farmer for farmer empowerment. We have book and knowledge for example, for cucumber, selling the cucumber seed, selling the food, the tools for agriculture, selling and buying fresh cucumber. Also, all that we done is about the micro for my farmer, for micro, for small enterprise. This is the Bina Swadaya beneficiaries. And that all we done in microfinance, in assistant, in training center, training provider, agriculture shop, etc. is for our beneficiaries. And we call it, this is a social impact, so social enterprise that we should done for Trubus Bina Swadaya company. We also pushing ourselves to digital because digital is even digital is not a new innovation, but our management, our staff still have a lack of management, lack of digital. So we should pushing. We helping all people doing the digital process. So we try to give them free online webinar. We promoting urban farming. We promoting food self-sufficiency. And the goal is income generating and also food security in family level. We have many program in webinar. All is I think is urban farming from the family member. Okay. And every Saturday we have a free webinar. All is free webinar because we have a Kelas Trubus. Kelas Trubus is a training class from Trubus. Trubus is our brand for magazine and for agriculture shop. Our beneficiaries for 5 webinar is more than 2,000 person. This is only for 5 webinar. And we also have the Trubus talk using the Instagram live on Wednesday for virgin coconut oil versus coronavirus, tea talk, hydroponic from home, the art of jamu. Jamu is a traditional herb from Indonesia. All that we have done for people who should stay home. Cooperation with Ministry of Agriculture, we do online book review, and we give them agriculture extension staff free access for our e-books, because we have an e-book too in our online platform in Trubus Magazine. We have online training class that I mentioned before, that we have class Trubus, Trubus class. For early stage, we give them free, all is free. This is early stage is just hobby, just want to know about our program, like hydroponic, organic, herb. But we have also medium stage. This is a special price. And we give them a very, very special price. And expert class, we give special package because we give them off-taker for the product. For free class beneficiaries, more than 2,000 person. We also have sponsorship and partnership from our program. We collaboration with Medco Foundation, also Ministry and Tourism. We give training for tour leader, 50 participant from tour leader, because tourism already very, very going down. And we give them assistance. Also, we have a collaboration with Catholic Networking against the COVID-19. We also give them the food security program. All of goal is a food security, food self-sufficiency campaign. For example, we train our beneficiaries catfish in the bucket. Catfish and vegetable in the bucket. This is a solution for urban area who doesn't have enough space. More than packet already distribute to around Jakarta, and next week will be distribute to cooperative members that all is a woman. As that food security, food self-sufficient is our campaign in social media. And we also have continuing our woman cooperative partner. We give them food support for cooperative member. This is collaboration with Aliansi Organik Indonesia. The farmer help the people to get the healthy food. Also, we give capital and marketing assistance to make a mask. And we buy their mask, and we do bundling product with agriculture need. Also, that I asked before, that we have kept restructuring during and after COVID-19. Demand in agriculture product is very high. Until May, that more than 100% planning is already reached. Last week, we sent a 2-foot container to Batam. We sent a compost from micro enterprise product to Batam. And we delivery 2-foot container. It's very big for us. We changed our training center from from MICE, from meeting, become online and delivery healthy food because our fresh product supplier need us to buy their product. And in new normal in hospitality in Bisma Hijau, that is a facility for training, we also do the new standard operating procedure. We cleaning, we sterilize, strictly standard of healthy eating and safety food. Also, we providing a healthy food, and we still have the home delivery service for healthy and safety food. For all that we have know that places are opening because of economy, and we need to economy too, not because it is safe, and we should prepare become a new and non-normal. Like this, Pak Indro.
Okay, thank you, Ibu Emil. On time the presentations. So I would like to invite a participant. If you want to ask a question, please, I will now open for the question and answer session. You can open your microphone and also video, and then you can raise your question directly. No question yet? Okay.
Hello,
Nicholas.
I'm Nicholas from India. Thank you very much. Nice to listen to all of you, and very nice to see that how through community activity, you have made a self-sufficiency and a self-reliance, sustainable living. I think that's a very good thing. Maybe I would like to ask how the other business groups, like different companies, multinational companies and national companies, the big players, and your role. How do they clash, or how they are not? You do not allow them. How it is like that?
Sorry, can you repeat again the last?
No. The big companies.
Yeah.
Big companies, say multinational companies, and your this cooperatives, small cooperatives, do they clash sometimes in this business, or they go smoothly? How it is?
Okay, Bu Emil, this is a question from Pak Nicholas, yeah, from India. So he is actually asking how the situation now is, whether like a big companies and maybe transnational companies, whether they are also like a clash, or they are it's like a fight with the like a small or even micro enterprise. What is the situation now? Whether there is like a tight competition, or even like class, or they are actually walking each other. Yeah. Or is the experience of Bina Swadaya on this?
Yeah, right.
Okay, Pak Nicholas, regarding our presentation, that even the big company like Medco Energy, also another big company going down too, because they cannot do anything in the side, but they always hand in hand with us to working together to support our community. That like webinar with Medco, we help a community for 600 person around Indonesia, because Medco Foundation, Medco Energy, also have community outside Jakarta in the rural area. We already work with Ministry of Agriculture to also the other company. Even they have a hard situation, even they should retirement person, but they still have in Depok, in Mekarsari, that our office located. We also hand in hand with other company to give the local community staple food. Also, we have a portable hand wash. Yeah, something like that.
Okay. Yeah, nice. Means going smoothly. Both parties are going smoothly. That's a good thing. Yeah, nice. Thank you.
Yeah. Always going smoothly, Pak Nicola. So far, in at least in our walk, yeah, we close hand in hand, yeah, with the like the big companies, and also we still continuing with the micro enterprises, which is become our partner. And as addition, actually, Bina Swadaya also become like a several like a network who hand in hand together, like network how to give a solution during this pandemic. So we are also working with like a many like a community and like a social organization and also big company. For instance, how to support like the, you know, like the hospital and then medical care with the tools, yeah, to face the COVID-19, you know, for the hospital, something like that. We distribute many health tools to them, like mask and also test kit, yeah, for the COVID-19. But we also do like a solidarity in term of especially for small marginal people who lost their job, who have a difficult situation because of pandemic. And besides of the government support also for the, you know, like a donation, yeah, what we call is social support from the government. But in the community or in the civil society, we also hand in hand, we raising you know, like a collective money together also from the big company. And then we have like also independent or like like independent support to our community who really impacted for the COVID-19 in our local. So I think this is really good example because we have here experience, and then it is related with our actually Indonesian culture, what we call it like a gotong royong. It's gotong royong meaning that we work together. This is like a main, what is like a philosophy or main character of our nation, of people. That's why during a difficult situation, normally we will have, you know, work together with government, with the people, and also with the company. Everybody, we should hand in hand to face this difficult situation. Okay, Nicholas?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so I see in the chat, there is a question from, I think, I see from...
Ani.
Yeah? Okay, yeah. Ani from... So Korea, thank you for your presentation. I was so impressed that Trubus Binaswaya quick response against COVID-19 crisis. I wonder you did food catering, agriculture business before COVID-19 also. Okay, Ibu Emil, maybe you can answer the question from Ani asking whether we already have the like food catering business and agriculture before COVID-19.
Yeah, Ani, that before we have agriculture shop in, I think it's in 16 or 17 located, but we just selling the agriculture product for hobbyists, only for hobbyists. During the COVID, it's very, very high demand. I think that all people around in Indonesia is doing agriculture in at home. So like Batam, we don't have a branch office in Batam, but we should share compost in Batam. Also from Trubus magazine is agriculture magazine that we have already since 1967. Now Trubus magazine become the only one magazine, agriculture magazine in Indonesia. And that everything that we write in magazine become popular. So in agriculture shop, we try to provide something like durian, mangosteen. We prepare in agriculture shop. How about the catering? How about the food? Catering and food is not our main business before, because our main business in MICE, meeting, incentive, and conference. But because of COVID, now catering become our main business. We switching our business process. Agriculture services is our main business, because Bina Swadaya established because of farmer. So agriculture, we all of product based on agriculture, even in books, magazine, training services, also microfinance. For the first time, we provide for agriculture. Like this, Pak Indro.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so basically what Ani said is asking is yes, Tubus Bina Swadaya is already have this kind of business before, but like Ibu Emil say, like catering is not a main business, but because of now, meeting, conference is cannot be done. So that's why we have to switch our business. So then we're pushing for the catering as our main activity at the moment, because there are quite high demand for this, yeah, online food, and also like you know, like online food is very happening at the moment. So that's why, and also catering, because some of the companies, they are still operating during pandemic. So that's why this has become one of the concentration at the moment to pushing the catering business. And also for the agriculture, which already become our business before COVID-19. Okay. Next question I read here from Jasmine Gutierrez, I think. So with slowing down of business everywhere, will you be able to keep all staff employed in all your business unit? What measure are you taking to do this? So I think it is clear to Emil what happened with our business, with our staff, whether we can keep all staff remain with us, and what the measure that we put for this. Okay, so please, to Emil, can you explain?
Yeah, COVID-19 is very hard situation for us, especially for me, because of course that we cannot keep all our employee. We have a daily worker, we have a contract, unpermanent staff, and also we have permanent staff. During the COVID, for daily worker, we should stop most of daily worker. And from, for example, from they work for 6 days a week, we cut become 3 or 2 days until now, from 1600 employee, all employee from daily for contract base or also permanent staff, all of daily worker already cut, and several contract base is we just waiting that the contract is already finished. Until now is 150 person already stop, and we will call them again after the normal business, hopefully.
Okay, so there's the question, the answer from Bu Emil. Yes, we also have a difficult situation. We cut at least around now at the moment around 15 to 20%.
Yes.
Yeah, 150 from 600 employees. Some we are not continue the contract, But we trying, as Emil said, during situation is back to normal, our business also become rise again, and then we will again invite them to work again with us, because this is the difficult situation. And as addition, we also, I think Ibu Emil also mentioned in the presentation, we also do some cost efficiency. We also cut the salary of the staff, yeah, and also the director, the management as well. So this is the part of the solidarity during this COVID. But it is lucky that we are still survive until now. But if the situation is worse and then the lockdown is still happening, then it will be more suffering for us and maybe more, you know, more workers will be stopped to work with us. But now is situation is better because some of the lockdown is already open. So then we can start part of our business. We can also start the business as usual. So hopefully that we can still continue and then survive our business, as well as we can keeping support our partner, especially for the small social enterprise. Okay, I will continue. There is a question from Mendoza. Okay, do you profile your member in terms of economic status and gender? For example, woman-led social enterprise. Are there any differentiated COVID-related challenge to social enterprise among those with different economic status and gender? Okay, I think it's quite clear. Emil?
I will add the Jasmine question. Even we should cut off our employee, but we still help them, give them donation. Also, we give them staff output because we really sad about this situation. And about the profile member in economic status and gender. For cooperative, most of them is 100% our member cooperative is a woman, micro enterprise for women, because we adopted in ASA for Bangladesh. But our beneficiaries like from shop agriculture, also in community empowerment, this is a mixed gender. We have profiled our beneficiaries. And the challenge about the social enterprise economic status and gender, we still don't have data. We still don't have research about this. Sorry.
Yeah, I want to add something about this. So under Bina Swadaya, we have like a cooperative, what we call is Koperasi Bina Swadaya Nusantara. And beside of this cooperative, we also have like rural banks in, I think, 2 or 3 locations in Indonesia. So two locations and the cooperative. So these 3 entities, cooperative and then 2 rural bank, we give serve to mostly small, even micro entrepreneurs, micro enterprises. So they are also affected by this, pandemic. Yeah, and for sure we have the data, the profile about who have a loan or who working with us. Based on gender, based on their business, with their economic, with their activities. But so far, we don't have recent yet how much of this really affected because of this COVID-19, which sector which is really affected. But in general, we saw from the report from the director of this cooperative and also from the rural banks that it is in general affected to all of our partners, our debitors, yeah. Who are working with us. So that's why this in general situation. That's why, like Emil already mentioned, we also give some relaxation for this our partner to you know readjust the installment yeah of their loan, something like that. So this is also our way to support this micro enterprise. Pak Bambang, you want to add something? Maybe.
Unmute, Pak.
Unmute, Pak Bambang.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, Pak Bambang.
During the COVID 19 situations, I observe in Indonesia is the spirit of cooperation. Formerly, very hard to cooperate with the government. The government always look at to NGOs as the, you know, something that is not important at all. But during this situation, the government realized that they only can do something if they really involve people in the partnership. So in Indonesia, usually we heard about public and private partnership, but they neglected the role of people. Now, I think the spirit of public, private, and people partnership is there. Binas Wadaya is looking this situation as the opportunity to promote further cooperation in the future. And this Binas Wadaya is promoting rural development through what we call movement for revitalization, revitalization movement. And it will kind of cooperation among the stakeholders, the local government, private, and also NGOs. So this is we see as an opportunity to work closer in the future. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for your addition, Pak Bambang. Is there any other question from participant? I think if you want to share also, I think we will come. Or here is also I see like Ibu Ira. was staff in Binas Wadaya as well. Any other question or comment? So
thank you, Pak Indro. I'd like to add a little bit. Binas Wadaya has a unit of disaster. What's the name, Bu Emil? You can add it.
Humanitarian response. And emergency response.
Okay, humanitarian and emergency response. So, in every disaster, Binas Wadaya can respond so quickly by having this unit. That's a very good unit. And it is really necessary for you all to have this unit in your organization. Thank you. I think that's all, Pak Indro.
Okay, thank you, Bu Ira. Basically, Binas Wadaya is already mentioned by Pak Bambang. We are maybe a pioneer, or maybe including the first NGO in Indonesia. It founded in 1967, so it is more than 50 years now. We are working in all over Indonesia. Yeah, so we do like Pak Bambang mentioned. We work closely with the rural communities and also with the small micro enterprises in many places in Indonesia. and to sustain or to be more self-reliance, we and to be not dependent in or like a donor agencies or like from the donation, Bina Swadaya also set up like a company under this foundation. As Ibu Emilia mentioned, we have several companies in agribusiness, like retail, and then also in the publication, in the magazine. We also have like a training center, which is a MICE for the meeting, incentive, conference, event, yeah. And then we also have, for sure, if we have MICE, we also have like a kitchen who can serve food. And then now it's also pushing, expanding to be have a catering services as well as for the online food. And we also working with our partners for our micro enterprise who also produce like processed food. We accompany them. We trying also to become off taker and then to buy their product and then also sell through this company under the food delivery and selling. Yeah, and then we also have what we call is like cooperative, as I mentioned, and also the rural banks who also serve for mostly for the people like with the small loan and small business and also micro enterprises. And beside that, we also have like a consultancy and also support like company when they're doing a corporate social responsibility. So we are working with the company to develop their CSR program. We do some consultancy as well as also the accompanying the people surrounding the company. So we have some cooperation in several parts of Indonesia. So basically we are quite big in terms of geographical because we are working all over Indonesia, and in terms of sector, we can say like that, we also work in many different sectors. We have training center, we have publication, we have media, and also we have also like retail, yeah, who working also with many smallholders farmers who become our supplier in terms of providing like compost, organic fertilizer, and also seedling to us. And we have also some like consultancy and also like advocacy as well. So we are quite diverse in our activity, in our business, but we also keeping to support and continuing support like rural and also small enterprise and business. And at the moment we have like a big, what you call it, like maybe like a missions, like Bambang already mentioned. We have now working with the movement of rural revitalization or rural revitalization movement. So this is become our tagline where we trying to give a holistic approach in terms of supporting the development in the rural areas. For sure, we will still using our main approaching by empowering like self-help group, cooperative, as a tools to empower and to drive on the economic in the rural areas. And we are lucky, as Pak Bambang mentioned, now government is more open to work with the NGOs. And also now also the Indonesian government also spending some money fund for the village. This means that we can also work with the village government as well as the farmers and then the people in the village how to develop their economy and their villages. So this is also what we are now doing a focused work with the people in the rural area. Okay. Is there any other question?
Yeah, Pak Indro. I'm curious to know from Jasmine.
Okay. Jasmine.
Hello.
Okay, I'm curious to know how you are able to use the CADR to handle lack of internet connectivity of your community partner. In webinar, in online training, we just give them knowledge. And for example, for catfish in the bucket, for us is very easy how to see it, how to plan, how to maintain the water, the catfish. But for community, it is very difficult. And then we have a small group in WhatsApp. And also we asked to media program to make a small video step by step how to planting the seed, how to move from seed to the bucket, something like that. And we train the CADR, the local CADR, who has a good connection, a good internet connection, to train the other member, something like that. Because, for example, for Medco community, they live in Sumatra, in Kalimantan, also in Papua. Even they don't have they still have this land to agriculture activities. But they want to know about the catfish in the bucket. So we make a small video that can upload in WhatsApp, only 3 minutes. Also, we engage them in the WhatsApp group, and they teach the other member something like that. Even in Jakarta, our community in cooperative community, we teach them how to make a good mask. Also, we should guide them by phone if they don't have smartphone. Even in Jakarta, several members still don't have smartphone, and they always ask our team, is it is okay? They take a picture. Is okay or not? So far, it's worked. Even if we need more effort to from knowledge become a skill, something like that. Jasmine.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much, Amelia. That is really very helpful. And I think we can do a similar thing here with our groups, particularly those who are in the upland communities, by using your CADR concept. Thanks.
Yes, yes. There is question. Okay, thank you, Jasmine. There is also another question from Marion. Yeah, in most area, hospitality business, including catering services, are very much affected by the lockdown. My impression is that you were able to continue with these activities. How were you able to do this, Emil?
Catering. Everyone that still stay home. Need food, healthy food is become our concern. I think that not only in Indonesia but around the world. And we think that we have a capacity, we have knowledge about how to prepare safety and health food. Wisma Hijau catering services, we should provide the hospital from government hospital, they should provide the doctor and the nurse who against the COVID-19. Because of the experience, we think that where we do not expand our business, we try from the small home service delivery. Also, because the big company getting done, and we have fasting month too, is from and COVID, and fasting month is very hard to us to sell the catering product. So we try from door to door in home, selling our product, and We also asked to our kitchen to make frozen food because frozen food also the high demand. Everyone afraid to go to the fresh market and something is boring if they still cooking. We take the opportunity from the catering. Even we take the opportunity, but we still can help our partner, our supplier is micro enterprise. We have a partner in Bogor, in Puncak, to who always deliver the vegetable to us. That's just maybe the feeling or the opportunity, just combine.
Okay, so maybe I can add also what Emil is already mentioned. Yeah, basically our hospitality business is already also can say is closed. Because during pandemic, there is no more visitor, there is no more training program, there is no more group using our places. Okay, since let's say March until now, there are still no visitors, no group of people who using our training center. So that's why we have to think how we can survive. That's why, because in the hospitality business, we have like a kitchen. That's why we now is pushing. We utilize this capacity of our kitchen to do more. Before, we also already have like catering business actually, but this is not like Bu Emil mentioned, this is not our main business. But now during COVID-19, then we pushing much on the catering business because now food delivery is very much demanding during pandemic. People is ordering food, yeah, from online. Now we also do the same. We're trying to use all the opportunity like Ibu Emil mentioned. We are also trying to selling like frozen food. We also ready food. We also work with the company, government, hospital who are still working during this pandemic. Yeah. So we're trying to do some, you know, like presentation, offering, something like that to this. But for sure, this is not, you know, if you use, we are not, profiting from this. Even for survival, it is still difficult because before our main income is come from the hospitality business. At the moment, from the catering, which is not, ready yet to be like a big. That's why we are trying to pushing, but at least it can cover the operational cost of the workers who work with this unit. So that's why at least we can survive. Honestly, at the moment is only, shop, our retail shop who are profit from this situation because like Ibu Emilia mentioned, now in Indonesia is growing demand or growing trend to have what we call is like home gardening, home gardening, like to do like poly bag and then farming in the poly bag, yeah, and also aquaponic, hydroponic in the at home. So the demand of this kind of activity now is very high. That's why now we benefited also from this trend. As Bu Emilia also mentioned, we do also many webinars related to home gardening. And in Indonesia also, the government also campaigning about the home gardening. That's why this is benefited to us. Now our like a retail get the benefit from this. This is the only, let's say, business that profitable during this pandemic situation. But all other business, all other activity, we can say this is still in survival mode. But we have to try. We have to adapt. We have to find a solution. We have to be creative during this situation. At least until now, we still can survive. And even we can also keep supporting our partner, our micro enterprises, partners. Okay. Okay. Jasmine. Okay, Jasmine, I think it's S. Thank you. Okay, is there any other question? No?
No, I think so.
No? Okay. Pak Bambang, do you have something for the closing for Bina Swadaya before I give my time to Lisa?
Yes.
Closing.
According to the business what is classification, I would say that in Indonesia is more than 90% of the business are in micro business. This micro business is not quite well served by the program of microfinancing up to now. A lot of opportunity, a lot of experiences, but it doesn't make a kind of microfinance industry in the country, like in India, in Bangladesh, and in other African countries. In Indonesia, this is really very much depend on the banking institutions. But the banking institutions are not capable to serve the unbankable clients. And the unbankable clients are micro enterprise. And the total people involved in micro enterprise is more than 90% of the, and it's according to the Ministry of Cooperative is about 60 million micro enterprise. I think soon after pandemic is over, the problem of financing of micro enterprise is in, we are facing them very much, because before the pandemic, the problem is there, and during the pandemic, everything related to their capital is lost. So I think we have to really think very very hard how to find a solution about it. Cooperation among the financial institutions, government, and NGO should be there. And I think this is our homework to think about that. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak Bambang. Okay, before I pass to Lisa, I want to conclude. Emil, you want to say something before? No?
Okay. Yeah. COVID-19 is very hard, not just for us, but also for our business. But we still try to raise again together with partner. And this is our vision, our mission, also our passion, that we work together for poor people, for get a better life, something like that.
Okay, thank you. Actually, you already conclude what I want to conclude as well. So I think I'm not necessary to add more. Lisa, I think this is all that we are from Bina Swadaya Foundation. Maybe this is for us. Thank you very much. I hope this can be a lesson learned, yeah, for all other partners in Asian country, what we facing the difficulties during the COVID pandemic, and why we still trying to keep survive and also to sustain, to continue supporting the micro enterprises and also women and other small business in Indonesia. Okay, thank you, Lisa.
Thank you very much, Indro, and thank you very much, Pak Bambang and Emil. The Bina Swadaya team actually presented how Trubus Bina Swadaya, which is a group of social enterprises that is well known in Indonesia, how they managed to survive, no, the downturn caused by COVID-19, and their focus on promoting self-reliance has actually assisted them to optimize the internet as well as focus on agriculture to sustain their support for households, for health workers, for farmers, for cooperatives, self-help groups, communities, villages, and the micro-enterprises that you have focused on. I guess all of us have been severely affected, and it's phenomenal that Bina Swadaya, Trubus Bina Swadaya, as a group of social enterprises, is keeping the tradition of social entrepreneurship alive and well. Because I think more than ever, given the pandemic and its aftermath, we need more social enterprises. And with Bina Swadaya's example, we believe that there is hope for social enterprises to actually be a lead actor in the effort to recover as well as build back better. And I think, as Pak Bangbang was saying, I think the recovery and building back better phase is only possible if social enterprises work with NGOs together with the private sector and government to actually work together towards building a better society. And I think it would be the social enterprises and the non-government organizations that would make possible the people cooperation with public and private, or in the public-private people partnership that Pak Bambang was talking about. So thank you very much, Bina Swadaya, for a very enlightening presentation. I think given the complicated operations you have, 1.5 hours is really not enough, no, to really explain that. And maybe there can be some other ways that you can share what you have done and what you continue to do in Indonesia. No? And maybe the web page that we are creating, where we will be uploading your video, can also have other materials from Bina Swadaya. Of course, the challenge is always the language, no? Because of course you have a lot of materials in Bahasa, and we will need to upload things in English. But having said that, thank you again to Bina Swadaya. Let's give them a big hand. And at the same time, I'd like to thank everyone for joining us in this webinar series. And we would also like to invite everyone to the next webinar series on June 23, when we feature Gandang Kalikasan, or Human Nature, in the Philippines, in terms of how they also manage their stakeholders to survive the pandemic and to manage to sustain their operations. So with that, I'd like to thank everyone. And this is not the end, because we still have a webinar series that goes until September. So thank you very much, everyone. Thank you, Pak Bambang. Thank you, Indro. Thank you, Emilia. And see you again in the succeeding webinars.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Keep healthy.
Yeah, good.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. See you again in the next webinar series.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.